everybody, and welcome to Fix It Friday.
One, two, three, four.
Birthday in 60, 70, 80. I got 2-2. Let's go.
Guys, today is a day when I go over things that I think can be improved amongst the Krav Maga, MMA, and martial arts world. And today we're talking about a technique we do in Krav against an attack from the side. The attack we're talking about is a two-hand choke from the side. Very common attack, especially amongst domestic violence. So what's happening, he's trying to choke me. And I got to get this off of my neck. I got to get this choke away from my neck. In Krav, we always address the immediate danger. The immediate danger is actually his thumbs only. So without his thumb, it's hard or maybe even impossible. You can try and see what happens to choke me. So he needs the thumb. So we do what's called a pluck. We put our hands in kind of a hooking motion, and we go up explosively and we pluck the hand off of our neck. And then we do whatever we have to do in order to go home safe. Well, let's talk about three things I see students do that can be improved with this technique. For one is the pluck. They don't pluck. They come in, you choke a little hard, don't let me go, and they try to pull the thumb off the neck. It's very, very difficult. And even worse, David, what they do is they grab the wrist. So choke, right? I'm not doing anything. So you don't want to do that. What you want to do is try to explosively pluck at the meaty part of the thumb. You go up and you pluck explosively. Now, with that being said, I don't have to get the hand all the way down here. Long as I get choke hard, as long as I get here, I'm good. That's the only thing I need. I just need to be able to breathe. Which brings me to the second thing. The second thing is they do a good pluck and their hand goes too low. It looks like this. Well, one, yes, he rechokes. So I go here and he rechokes. I go here and he rechokes. I don't want to do that. What I want to do is control the hand. If my hand goes lower, then your hand is closer to the neck and you're going to rechoke or hit me or whatever. So I want to pluck and keep control of the hand. The next thing is the direction of their combatives. So he starts to choke. If he's really close to me, what they do is they come in and they try to throw these elbow strikes coming into their attacker. You don't want to go into your attacker. You need space. You need space to work. So what I do, I like to lean out to throw my elbow strikes, my hammer fist strike, and then I have space in order to work. So again, to reiterate, the three things, number one, you make sure that you don't try to grab at the thumb or the wrist. Make sure you pluck explosively. Number two, make sure that you do not bring your hand down and keep their hand closer to your neck. And number three, give your spouse some space in order to do what we call our combatives. All right, guys, once again, my name is DJ. This is my man David, and we're giving you confidence during chaos. And showing you respect. Oh, don't forget to subscribe to our channel because we got more. So yo, when you choke, I choke real hard. And I'm gonna see if I can
choke hard.
Go. Yeah, see, I'm good. Then you go choke hard.
Okay, go.
Yeah, see right here. So I guess it'll work.
Yeah, because you created just enough space.
Exactly,
for you.
Exactly. All right, man, see you later.
Cool.
We'll be right back.